Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. It's Thursday, August 9th, 2012, and I'm Captain Dave Owen. Over the weekend, we held our Friendship Festival, and it was a pretty good event. We brought on nearly 43,000 guests, and we sold 3,210 pizzas. So that's a measurement of how well the Friendship Festival went. And I want to thank the USS Fitzgerald in particular. They were the visit ship, and they managed to push over 12,000 people across the ship in that short period of time, and that was quite a feat. So thanks to the Fitzgerald and your good work there. I got some not-so-cool stuff to talk about, though, first. Last weekend, we did have another DUI. That makes three in 3 weekends. That's not a good thing. This individual blew a .109 on the BAC. I've said it many times before. If you're going to drink, do not get behind the wheel of a vehicle. We've got sobriety checkpoints out there. Good chance we're going to catch you. So be smart out there. If you're going to drink, do not get behind the wheel of a car. And also, if you're going to drink, please do it responsibly. We had a sexual assault reported from over the weekend, and no surprise, it involved alcohol. Individual was about the same alcohol content as the DUI. He's like a .108. And it impaired his judgment, and he did something that he shouldn't have done. And as a result, we had another sexual assault report that came out from over the weekend. So please, if you're going to drink, again, drink responsibly. We've had a rash of something that's happened recently that is kind of unusual at the auto port. Over the last week, we've had about 3 or 4 cases of people pumping gas into their car and driving away without paying for it. We don't have the pay at the pumps here on the installation. We're going to get those eventually. I don't have the timeline, but please remember, when you pump gas in your car, they do have the cameras on you and everything. Please pay for your gasoline. Don't go driving away. It's kind of embarrassing. I know in some cases they just forgot or it slipped their mind and the other things they were thinking about, but it's kind of an embarrassment to show up in the desk journal because you drove away without paying for your gas. And I saw something this morning. I saw this once before when I was walking around the base. It's been a while. A driver driving down the street passed by me, and he was shaving while driving. He had one of those razors with the batteries operated in it, and he's looking in the rearview mirror, shaving his face. I'm sure he was not being very attentive to the road while he was trying to groom the whiskers on his face. So please, do not go shaving while you're driving down the road, okay, guys? Do not shave your face. And women, definitely don't try to shave your legs while you're driving a car. That would be probably pretty dangerous. So let's pay attention while we're driving out there. All right, some things coming up this weekend. On Saturday, the Ikego Community Flea Market is going to hold a community flea market. So all you flea marketeers, here's a chance for you to go down to Ikego and enjoy the day at the flea market. Also, the George Washington is having their change of command on Saturday. So you'll see some busyness going on down around that area on the base. Again, on Saturday is the George Washington change of command. Next week on the 17th is the Honch Patrol. So those who want to go out and help clean up the community, Honch Patrol is on the 17th of August. And then on the 18th of August up at Negishi, we got another open base event. This will be for their Bon Odori. I don't anticipate 3,000 pizzas being sold at this one, but the Bon Odori does usually get a pretty good turnout. If you're not too sure how to do the Bon dance, I hear Lieutenant Thornton and Kyoko-san from PAO are Bon dance experts, okay? So you can go get them and learn how to do the Bon dance. Well, they'll be up there at Negishi. On the following day, the 19th of August, we are expecting a demonstration down at the main gate at Kearney. It'll run from 16:30 to 17:30. They're predicting anywhere from up to 150 people will be down there doing their protest during that time frame. We're not anticipating closing the gates. As usual, the protests and demonstrations are really, really peaceful. They sit there, they do their chants, and they start when they say they're going to, they stop when they're going to, and they disperse. But just for your own situational awareness, there will be a demonstration down at the main gate on the 19th of August. Hey, kiddies, I hate to remind you of this, but school is going to be starting up here before much longer. August 27th is when the first day of school here for the day of schools at CFAY. So that date is coming fast and furious. Get your school supplies together and people be aware that the kids will be going back to school and they'll be out walking around in the mornings to and from, and you'll see the school buses running around again here pretty soon. FX funding. Well, everybody wants to know, what is FX funding? Well, maybe you don't want to know, but FX funding is what we are provided to pick up the trash on the base, to cut the grass, to trim the bushes. And in FY13, we're going to take a very big budget cut on that area, in the FX funding area. So we're going to be revising and putting out the new cleanliness instruction. Something we're going to be looking for was, we're going to ask if tenants would like to take ownership of an area, maybe, you know, keep it clean, cut the grass, do some trimming of it. There's going to be more on this to come forthwith, but the problem is we're not going to have the funds to keep the grass cut down and pull the weeds that we used to. So we're going to need some help in order to keep CFAY looking good. Captain's Cup Sports, we got a couple events coming up this month, track and field event and dodgeball. Here's your opportunity to go out and throw the dodgeball around. Remember, we still want to dethrone subgroup 7. Maybe we'll get lucky and Lauren will play on the mouth that can't be ignored. Lauren will play on the subgroup 7 dodgeball team, and we can nail her with a dodgeball or so. I've asked the hospital if their XO is going to participate, because we've got a special vest for her with a bullseye on it. So you can go out and throw the dodgeball at maybe the XO of the hospital if USNH can convince her to come out and play in a game. But there's some good fun to be had there. Remember, there is life after the military, so take advantage of your educational opportunities while you can. Use that tuition assistance. Get yourself a degree. Right now, Navy College is doing registrations for the fall semester and classes. So get on down there to the third floor of Fleet Rec, see the representatives at either Central Texas College or University of Maryland or University of Phoenix. Get that associate's degree or that bachelor's degree or even potentially that master's degree. Here's your opportunity. So if you got the time, get yourself some courses under your belt. The Yokosuka Bay Stars, the minor league team for Yokohama, will be playing in Apama this weekend. So anybody wants to go see some minor league baseball, they've been on a pretty good streak lately. They've been winning some games. And Saturday and Sunday, first pitch, 1,800, and it's only 1,000 yen to get in. So I encourage you, get out there to the Yokosuka Bay Stars. And I'd like to do a welcome to Daisy. Daisy is the newest member of our military working dog team, just reported to us. She was already out working busily over the weekend. She's an explosives dog. You might have seen her sniffing some vehicles coming through the gate. So welcome to Daisy. I'll see if I can get her a picture or get her on the show here soon. Now on to the trivia. The movie that I was looking for from the last video was No Way Out. And the answer was given to me, Lauren Nichols. Thank you, Lauren. The song I was looking for was Burnin' Love by Elvis Presley, and Jessica McFarlane gave me that answer. And the sports question, the answer was Denny Stark and Kevin Millward in 2002. That was the last time before what happened recently. Two starting pitchers, each starting pitcher hit a home run in that game, and Courtney's, I hope I get this last name right, Suessese, S-U-E-S-S-E, gave me the answer for that one. So thank you very much. When I reviewed the video I made the last time, I noted I said what the movie was, but I forgot to do the shout out to the person who gave me the answer. And for that one, that was the movie I was looking for, was King Kong, and Nico De Los Santos had given me that answer. Sorry, Nico, I missed your name when I did the last video, but I hope I made up for it there. All right, three new trivia questions. Here's a TV show. Who lived at apartment 201 in Santa Monica, California? Give me the show and the characters. And that one may be a little harder than some of the other ones I've done in the past. Okay. The song, give me the title and the audience. Yeah, I was always the lazy one, a Southern Californian. But I've got some kinfolk on the Mason-Dixon line. So you can come up with what that song is and who the artist is. And my sports question, well, one of my favorite Major League Baseball teams, the Cleveland Indians, has managed to lose 11 consecutive games, which leads me to this question. What is the record for the most consecutive losses by a Major League Baseball team? And we'll go for two answers, who did it in the American League and who did it in the National League. All right, that wraps up the trivia questions. Hey, next week, CFAY, my next video is going to be a full-blown Commander's Corner. I'm going to have guests on. And with college football coming up, I'm going to do the inevitable. I'm going to try once again to pick the 10 teams that will go to the BCS Bowls. I've been under 500 the last 2 years, so maybe this will be my breakout year. We'll see what happens. As usual, CFAY, good shipmates. Don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs, and good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great weekend, CFAY.